My name is Ryan Kliethermes and I'm an engineer at KE2 Therm Solutions. Welcome to another technical support video. Today we are going to cover what to do when you arrive at a job site and find a KE2 Evap controller with a blank screen. First off, don't panic. The controller has been engineered with multiple levels of electrical protection to ensure the controller provides years of trouble-free service. It is important to remember sites have power issues from time to time. Typically, there are two main things to check on the controller to determine the cause. First, and I know this sounds simple, check to make sure you have the correct voltage at the incoming power connector. If it isn't the power, then it is probably the fuse. To check the incoming power, you'll need to have your multimeter available and set to the AC scale. Turn off power when preparing the controller. Once power has been disconnected, you'll need to remove the controller from its mounting location. If you're using the mounting box, simply turn the controller over and hang it from two of the mounting screws. If not, secure the controller in a safe place. Next, take off the back cover to expose the high voltage section of the controller. The voltage terminals are located on the top right corner of the KE2 Evap controller. If the controller has been prepared, safely return power to the controller so voltage can be measured. Place one probe from the multimeter on the top terminal location and the other on the bottom position. The voltage shown on the meter should match the intended power. If the reading is not correct, determine what is causing the issue and correct it. If not, proceed to the next step, checking the fuse. Checking the fuse is a straightforward process, but seems to trip up even some seasoned technicians. For safety, remove power from the controller. Then, remove the fuse by gently pressing down on the fuse holder and gently give it a quarter turn to the left. The fuse is spring loaded and should raise slightly in the correct position. The fuse holder can be removed by pinching it with your thumb and index finger. Once the fuse is out, remove it from the holder. It is important, I mention here, it is difficult, if not impossible, to determine whether or not the fuse is bad with the naked eye. Instead, use your multimeter, set for resistance, and measure the continuity across the fuse. If the fuse is open, contact your nearest KE2 Therm authorized wholesaler for a replacement. If the fuse is good, return it to the controller, being careful to depress the spring and turning it a quarter turn to the right. I hope this will help you when troubleshooting a blank controller. One other thing to consider, if the location has regular voltage issues, it may be best to ensure the controller is using 110-volt incoming power. For more information, please visit our website or contact our tech support line.